This is CBS 11 News Now.
Hey, good morning, everyone, and happy Monday. This is News Now, our digital update. I'm Jennifer Lindgren. First story this morning, Austin residents are on full alert after the fourth explosion in that city in a little more than 2 weeks. This latest explosion happened at about 8:30 last night in the southwest part of the city. Police say two men in their 20s were injured when they triggered a bomb on the side of the road. Both suffered serious injuries, but are expected to survive. Now remember, this is the latest in a series of explosions across Austin. Two people died and two others were hurt after three other package bombs detonated on doorsteps. Right now, it's unclear if last night's explosion is connected, but right now investigators are operating under the assumption that they could be linked. The reward for tips leading to an arrest has jumped to $115,000. Still too hot and still too dangerous. That is the word from firefighters about a fire still smoldering at a chemical plant in Crescent in Hood County. The mayor and assistant fire chief of the town southwest of Fort Worth made those comments yesterday. An explosion at the plant on Thursday led to that fire, which will now be allowed to burn itself out. Once that happens, crews will begin searching for Dylan Mitchell. He's been missing since the blast at Trichem Industries. Turning to our weather this morning, Jeff Jamison here to talk about the forecast. It was a little bit dreary Saturday evening, kind of all day yesterday, but it's going to change this week again.
It's going to be a dry week. Yes. It was very wet on Saturday night.
It just kept raining. St. Patrick's Day plans.
And that was not the best timing, but we do not have any rain for today. A lot of people may be watching this back at work or hopefully not watching at school. You need to be doing schoolwork right now. But we do have a spring break over here in North Texas, and it's kind of back to reality. Temperatures this morning are on the cool side, 50s and 60s. We have the biggest story of the day is going to be the wind. It's going to be a very windy day. Northwest winds 20 to 30 miles per hour, but plenty of sunshine. Temperatures in the mid-70s later today, so it's not a bad day in terms of the temperature. But that wind will be with us most of the week, including tomorrow and going into Friday as well. Now, tomorrow is the first day of spring. It begins at 11:15 a.m. on Tuesday, so today is the last full day of winter. And I don't think any of us are sad that winter's over, even though it wasn't a terrible winter.
No, we didn't have any snow.
We didn't have
huge icing events. I mean, we're kind of lucky.
That is true. We'll leave the icing events. We don't want those. I know a lot of people were kind of bummed that we didn't have any snow.
Yeah, I mean, you want like one day off school.
Yeah.
Just one day.
People want that snow day at school. It just didn't happen. And right now we're past the typical last freeze. So I think that we're probably done with wintry weather. And you can see the rest of the week, we'll warm up, be back in the 80s.
Can we keep it in the 70s and 60s for a little bit though?
Hold it there.
Like, I'm not quite ready for 89 degrees on Saturday yet. I don't know.
It's going to be pretty hot. In fact, if we get to 89, that'll be a near record high.
Yeah. Oh, great. All right. Something to look forward to. Thank you. Okay. For the first time since 1980, the state of Texas has had two teams dancing into the Sweet 16. Last night, A&M beat defending national champion North Carolina 86-65. What was that? The Aggies are headed to LA for the Sweet 16 for the second time in 3 years. They play Michigan in the West Regional Semifinals on Thursday night. Texas Tech also headed to the Sweet 16. Tech beat Florida 69-66. At the AAC Saturday night in front of a home crowd, practically. It's the first time the Red Raiders have advanced to the Sweet 16 since 2005. They'll play Purdue Friday night in Boston. All right, how's your bracket looking, Jeff?
Mine's okay. Now, Madison Sawyer is back behind her.
She's hiding back there, but she is in first place at the station right now.
She's not shy about letting you know about it either,
which is fine. I'm happy my Aggies won, though. We were watching that game at home yesterday, too. My husband was pretty excited about it.
Now, they're playing Doug Dunbar's Michigan coming up on Thursday, so we'll have to see what happens.
I mean, you got to go for the Aggies. They're kind of scrappy right now. They're just
right
knocking
now.
Everybody off.
More than 20 points against North Carolina. It's big time.
All right, good luck to them. A couple other things you may not know about. Number one seed Xavier lost to number 9 Florida State. TCU, unfortunately, lost to Syracuse, who then went on to beat number 3 Michigan State. University of Maryland, Baltimore County fell to K-State, unfortunately. But their game Friday night was one of the most fun basketball games I think I've ever seen when they knocked off Virginia.
That's right.
Remember that?
Never
number 16
before.
Beat number 1? Yeah, it was pretty incredible.
Now, how's your bracket? You doing all right?
It's not. It's been bad since like Friday. I mean, I think I had Virginia and Arizona going all the way to the Final Four.
I did read that, you know, every year they see if anyone can have the perfect bracket. And usually, I mean, it's just
a small sample.
It's happened a few times where someone has gotten it all the way through.
They need to be buying lottery tickets.
Nobody. Like, they've all been eliminated. Every single bracket is not going to win.
There have been some interesting upsets.
Very much. Well, yeah, you mentioned the biggest one, which nobody would ever thought that.
I know. All right. More to watch, of course, throughout the week this week. And thank you for watching CBS 11, The Ones for Texas. Remember, for the latest updates, head to cbsdfw.com. Of course, we'll have another Facebook Live News Now update coming your way at noon.